Hey everybody, it's Alan, and I hope that you're doing well. So a little while ago, I did videos talking about Billy Joel going on a talk show and being asked what songs would he want to hear his own band play if he was sitting in the audience watching himself perform. And he had this top five list that he kind of just flew off the top of his head. And one of those songs was this song, And So It Goes.
This is why my eyes are closed. It's just as well for all I've seen. And so it goes, and so it goes. And you're the only one who knows. So I would choose to be with you. If the choice were mine to make, but you can make decisions too, and you can have this heart to break.
That would be a part of the Billy Joel live show that would absolutely just tear me apart. Just him on stage alone, spotlight, middle of the stage, grand piano at his fingertips, just singing that song truly from the heart, probably every single time with the same amount of emotions that he probably showed when he was writing the song. The impact it must have had, and that particular situation where he could actually just solo in the middle of the stage by himself, give the rest of the band a breather. They don't have to hang out on the stage. They can just literally get a drink, whatever, get out of the spotlight, take 3 minutes and just you know, whatever, while he pours every bit of emotion out through his fingertips and his voice. Just spectacular. Great choice, Billy. Great choice. Yeah. I love the fact that in that particular interview he said, no, I like the deeper album cuts. I mean, after all, that is the entire basis behind my even starting this channel, is the fact that I like the deeper album cuts by a lot of different groups and not necessarily as many of the pop hits, which I like just fine. They're just overplayed. And the deeper cuts are really the album cuts that make me want to listen and listen more often. And again, you know, I can go off on a diatribe about this, and I'm going to try not to, but just the sheer and simple fact that we don't have artists really creating albums anymore. Sure, they'll record an album, they'll record an EP, but they won't back the whole thing. They won't push the whole thing. They will literally figure out what the hits are going to be and say, this is the 3-minute song that we can get on the radio, and this is the 3-minute song we can get a music video recorded for, or whatever it is. And it's like, there are so many great songs that aren't under 4 minutes long that people just need to listen to. I mean, how creative can you be in 3.5 minutes? You can be, obviously. So many artists have actually done it before. Go back in time. I mean, go look at the entire Buddy Holly catalog. Pretty much nothing in that catalog, or most anything in that catalog, is under 3 minutes, let alone 4 minutes. You know, but you got to wonder what Buddy Holly could have written had he actually tried to write something just to write it, and forget trying to stay within a time parameter. You know, the same thing goes true with so many other artists. Then you got artists who had the freedom to stretch, to go out on a limb, to really produce. And yeah, I could point to typical, you know, prog rock bands like Kansas or Rush or, you know, Yes or Genesis, and be like, yes, they pushed the limits. But so did the Beatles. And let's not forget that. Go listen to Sgt. Pepper. Go listen to the White Album. Go listen to Abbey Road and realize how many of their songs were stretched, how many of their songs weren't 3.5 minutes long, and yet because they were the Beatles, they could. Does that make sense? So you get to a certain degree of popularity or you know, fan support, and then you can actually do something much more epic. Dave Grohl's probably at that point right now where the Foo Fighters don't have to try to keep a song under 4 minutes. They can play a 6-minute long song. Pearl Jam can record a 6-minute long song. They're not trying to get on the radio anyway. They're just trying to create art that they enjoy and they love, and it doesn't bore them and they want to keep playing it. But so many, again, because of the constrictions of the recording industry over the course of the last 30 or 40 years, so many artists are stuck trying to create perfection in that much time. And it's so hard to produce quality, mind-altering, in-depth music in 3.5 minutes, which frankly is why I haven't listened to the radio in over a decade, because it's such formulated pablum that it does nothing for me. It really doesn't do anything for me. You know, I ain't a dancer. Simple as that. Anyway, with that said, that's one more from Billy's 5-song list that he said on that interview about songs that he would like to see his band perform if he were in the audience. So, hope you enjoyed it. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. Just know that I appreciate all of you, and I wish you well. Take care.